Hey everyone, Eric here from Nomadic Fanatic. Hope you guys are doing well. If you missed my very last video, I had a huge announcement. I will link that video up top for you if you're watching on your computer or phone there, because my life is drastically changing here very soon, and I know there's a lot of unknowns if you're following my channel and my lifestyle, and you probably have a ton of questions. As I hinted at in my last video, I am going to answer a lot of those questions and get you caught up with what the plan is here moving forward and how this new camper van is going to fit into my lifestyle. Also, at the end of the video, I appreciate all of the ideas and suggestions for naming. We are going to officially name the camper van. So thanks for joining me, guys. We got a big video today, though, and into tomorrow. So I will be uploading this video with some Nomad internet. Link below if you need some mobile unlimited internet. Let's get started. You know me, you know I change my plans all the time. I got the air conditioner back up here at base camp. I have also inflated and filled up the, well, it is a hot tub, but it's being used as a heated pool right now, set to 82 degrees in there. It's really nice because it is really, really warm still here in Illinois and very, very humid. And you may say, Eric, looks like you're getting ready to stay here for a little bit. Maybe. Maybe 2-3 weeks, maybe even up to a month. I've got my garbage coming back up to pick that up. And tomorrow, first thing in the morning, I mean, before it even gets light out tomorrow, we are leaving East Alton, Illinois, and I am driving 7.5 hours back up north to northern Michigan, not the UP, but northern Michigan, to pick up the camper van, and I'm going to share with you how we're going to do that exactly. Ironically here, Tater Tot, the smart car, has an issue. The air conditioning went out. I love, love, love dash AC. It's gone out and nobody can get me in until next month to get that fixed. We will get it fixed, but tomorrow is going to be a hot drive. It is going to be 94 degrees as we leave here in Illinois, but once we get up to Michigan, pouring rain and thunderstorms and temperatures in the 80s. So I'm at the drive with the windows down. We will not be talking or narrating while I'm driving 7.5 hours to pick up the camper van. How are we gonna pull this off? Well, I can tow the car, right? Well, the van, the camper van already has a tow package on the back. So I have taken off the Roadmaster Falcon gear so that I can hook all of this stuff with the light kit and the safety cables and everything and tow the car behind the van when we get to Michigan tomorrow. I know that sounds like a crazy idea, but it can be done and we're gonna be very, very careful. I'm gonna tell you all the rest of the details once we get on the road, because I've got a lot of work here to do at base camp. The kitties are gonna stay in the RV with both air conditioners running hooked into my 50 amp connection here at base camp. They are going to free feed for the next 24 hours, which means I'm gonna fill their bowls completely up and trust that they're going to take it easy. They're gonna have lots of water. They're gonna clean litter box to start. They will be fine for 24 hours. It's just not feasible to take them both with me on this quick little trip. But before we leave, as promised, I do want to talk about a few things here in my life that have changed. All right, so what is going on, Eric? Are you selling the RV? Are you selling Tater Tot? Are you selling your motorcycle? Are you selling base camp now, Eric? Calm down. Oh my gosh. It is hilarious to me how you guys sometimes just make up these alternate universes if I don't fill in all the gaps in every single bit. I just didn't want my video from 2 days ago to be 35 minutes long, but holy cow, no. No, I'm not selling my RV. I'm not selling Miranda. I'm not getting rid of base camp. Although, let's talk about base camp and that'll transition us into what my plans are with the van. Over the last 15, 16 months, I've been looking back at my life and some of the decisions I've made, some of the choices I've made. Some people have said, you're not nomadic anymore, Eric, because you have a house. I don't know what having a house has to do with not being nomadic. I've been on the road. But anyway, I personally have been doing a lot of reflection on my life lately, and I've been looking at some of the choices I've been making as far as base camp, although this isn't a place where I live. This is just a storage unit. This is my man cave arcade, somewhere to take a break from the road, somewhere to catch my breath and get some repairs done on the RV, to escape the rain and have some fun. And that's it. It's basically just a storage unit, okay? I'm still a nomad. But it has got me thinking, like, Eric, is this necessary? Like, do you need a 1930s slot machine, arcades and claw machines and pinball and a jukebox and more arcades? You know, this is what I love. This is what I need. It's what keeps me happy. Which brings me to my next point to transition into, and I'm not being critical of everyone on my channel, but we, and I'm including myself in this, we as spectators, it's easy for us to get really connected to someone we follow on YouTube. Believe me, I'm guilty as well. Something happens, they make a choice, and we're back here watching the TV screen like, why did you do it that way? Why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? Why did you do it that way? You're so wrong. And we all just gotta take a time out and say, wait a minute, we're being kind of selfish here. We have no idea what makes that person happy on the other side of the lens or the TV for this matter, but it's very easy to get caught up in what we think someone should do. And I'm asking you to just take a deep breath here and understand that I am my own person. I do things because I want to, and I do them to make me happy. I'm not gonna do everything that's gonna make you happy. That's why you have your own choices, and I'm not yelling at you. Okay, I'm gonna yell at you. You're doing it wrong! How does that feel? You know? But I'm trying to live a happy life. I've been comfortable lately, but also there's been some things in my life that I think going back, I would change if I had a chance. And we are gonna talk about Miranda. Again, I'm not getting rid of Miranda, my Class A RV, but as you all know, the circumstances from three and a half, maybe even four years ago, I had decided to sell my Class C RV no matter what. I was going to do it no matter what. I met someone who I thought also wanted to share their life with me and combine on the road that lasted, what, 16 days? And I had already bought Miranda, put a $15,000 down payment on it, and then that individual simply just took off, got back in her van that was just stored, and her life continued as normal while I'm sitting here like, oh, I got a 32-foot Class A RV for one person and one cat at the time. I don't have any remorse. I'm not, like, bitter about how things worked. It's just I got kind of stuck with something that I really didn't want by myself. I wanted to share that, but as time grew, I have slowly started to love my Class A. I love how much more powerful it is, how much more dependable it is. Really, except for the exhaust leaks, the slides, the leveling jacks. Wait a minute, there are quite a few things, but mechanically, just with the engine, the exhaust leak, and now the camshafts. Getting back on point, I don't want this to run too long. I started my nomad journey in a van. Many of my subscribers do not even know that. I started in a cargo van. It was not a camper van like this RV. I've actually lived in three different cargo vans with my cat. And then camper van Kevin graciously gave me Bertha, the black van that was partially converted. And then I did a few other upgrades to make that a little more comfortable for Jackson and I on the road. And I made it a home. And many of my subscribers either didn't follow those videos, or this happened before YouTube, and therefore y'all think I have to be in a Class C style motorhome. Maybe that's not what I want. I mean, I do. I actually do like Class C RVs, but I don't have any plans to go back to them. The camper van. Why did I get the camper van? Am I gonna never go back to the... No, guys. Again, the Class A is parked here at base camp, and I'm waiting for camshafts. Still, waiting to fix the RV. I'm looking forward to getting back in that RV and traveling that RV. In the meantime, instead of boring you with talking head videos from base camp or playing games that you guys don't care about, let's build a camper van. Let's restore this camper van. All we're gonna do is keep putting effort, time, and a little bit of money into the camper van to make her 100%, because these things are very highly sought after right now. Everybody out there wants a camper van, and you can expect to pay 3-4 times as much as you normally would have like 2-3 years ago. So for the immediate future, for the next few weeks, I'm gonna be building and working on the camper van here at base camp. I'm gonna continue to try to find camshafts for my Class A RV. And how I see this camper van fitting into my future travels is, when I get back to base camp, I can park the big Class A, I can move me and the kitties into the van, and we can go on different journeys in the van. Ones where it's not so important to have unlimited water and unlimited toilet storage in my gray and black tanks and power and all that, but maybe even go up to the Northeast in the camper van, or Florida, or California, or back home. If there's an emergency back home, or if I just really, really want to see my family and friends, take the camper van up to Washington State and come back. So I'm not deleting anything out of my life right now. I am simply adding one more tool in my arsenal, and I'm really excited about it, and I think you should be too. If you're really anxious to see me back in the Class A exploring, don't worry. Hopefully, fingers crossed, I've got my fourth order of camshafts currently being processed. In the meantime, we're gonna have some fun with the camper van, okay? So I'm gonna cut back in about 11, 12 hours when it's morning, and we will start this big journey. I gotta get some sleep.
I just woke up 15 minutes ago. This is incredibly exciting. It is the butt crack of dawn, guys. It is 4:38 in the morning, 78 degrees still. It never went down, and soaking wet humidity. No air conditioning, so I'm not going to be filming this 7.5 hour trip up north because I'm going to have the windows open and you won't be able to hear me anyway. But I'm going to put on some miles and at some point probably stop and get some more coffee. Here we go. I'm excited. Woo-wee. Oh man, I hit the halfway point. I am almost to Chicago, Illinois. Definitely my halfway point rest area. You know, this car is actually a lot more comfortable than driving the big Class A motorhome. Must be something about that seat position or something, but stopped here and officially got breakfast. Went with my McDonald's staple, the bacon, egg, and cheese McGriddle. You wouldn't like it. Delicious.
Oh yes. Hi Michigan. Thanks for reminding me. Couldn't you just get one day? Not one single day ever. Alright guys. That was a ton of driving. I'm pooped. I'm pretty much gonna go straight to bed here really, really soon. I have one big project on the RV. I'm running the air conditioner right now, plugged in and everything, testing out all my systems and everything. What I forgot to say was when I got this RV is that this RV is winterized. That means the water tank, the lines, the water heater, everything has pink antifreeze in it. So I've never winterized anything in my life. All of my RVs for my winterization is to go south. So I've been watching some YouTube videos on how to take care of this because we got to drain all that pink antifreeze out of there. And then we got to rinse and flush the system, followed by my version of sanitizing the drinking water holding tank that's under the bench in there. So my goal here is that in my very next video, I should be drinking water out of the tap on this RV. That is my goal. But I've got some work to do since I've got full hookups. I'm gonna hook up the RV and do the whole de-winterized flush system. That's gonna take me an hour, really boring, and then literally I'm gonna fall asleep. And I miss those kitties, but I'll check back in here when I wake up. Good morning, everyone, from the camper van. Get used to seeing the pooper in the shot. You're gonna see it a little smaller space here. I think I slept pretty good last night. I wore myself out cleaning out the water system. I did get everything clear finally after that pink antifreeze stuff, and it ran clear. Obviously, it's not safe to drink yet. I'm gonna stop at the store before I get back to base camp. I got half a tank of water under here. I'm gonna add one and three quarter cup of bleach and let that slosh around on the whole trip. That should sanitize it really good, and then we'll empty it and sanitize it later. I just don't think, I mean, don't get me wrong, it was really comfortable in here last night. However, I miss my kitties, and I miss them so much. I cannot wait to get this last 5.5 hours out of the way and go see them. Other than that, everything worked well. So yeah, here at the kitchen sink, everything coming out clear, both cold and hot, coming out clear. I wouldn't brush my teeth or drink from that water just yet. The fridge. Okay, so I fired up the fridge on gas last night. So there's the gas light lit right there. And can we read that? So I'm very happy that this old school refrigerator with the freezer ice box in there still works. I knew buying an older camper van, this is a 97, I knew there were going to be some things that weren't going to last very long. But, you know, this saves me a little bit of money. The air conditioner that actually works, it makes some noise sometimes, but it works. It doesn't run off the generator for whatever reason. It bogs down the generator, but I did order a soft start. Be putting that one in. Other than that, the only other thing is the water heater's not lighting up. So my fridge works on propane, my stove works on propane, my furnace even works on propane, although I don't like it, I'm probably not gonna use it. It's down there in a wasted space and I may pull it out one time, putting it in a Olympian Wave 3, but the water heater turns on, that light clicks off as if it's been started. If you go out there, it's just making a clicking sound. It's either starved or fuel or it's got a problem, and then the light comes back on and says fault. Can't get it lit up. It's really dirty too. I might have to clean it. Other than that, just gonna pack up everything, stop at McDonald's and get one more cup of coffee on the way out. And then start, once we get back to base camp, we'll start figuring out how I'm gonna put all this together and get some priorities done as far as solar and battery upgrades and stuff like that. Ooh, here at this Jellystone Park, I know I didn't show you any of it because it's like, it was pouring rain most of the time, but I did get a really cool custom Jellystone Park magnet and the wheels turn. It's kind of a neat little piece. So my first official van magnet. I don't have a lot of magnet space in here because I don't have an oven yet. I got plans, guys. I'm happy. I'm in a great mood. This van runs awesome. It's got so much power. Let's go put on some miles. All right, the sun is not up. Well, it's up there somewhere, but it is currently raining right now. Anyway, it's daylight. It's daylight now. We are 3 hours away from them kitties.
Lots of rain, lots of construction. Well, there's no construction. They don't really do much construction in the rain, I guess. Around these parts, but yeah, moist still.
I actually didn't bring the GoPro with me on this trip. I just brought my Sony, so it's not very wide angle. Can't get a cool view, but I love driving this van, guys. Man, it's so much fun. Anyway, I gotta concentrate. The next time I will cut back in, we will be at base camp to see them kitties. We are so close and the rain has just finally stopped. Look at this, guys. A tree fell on the freeway. Because the ground is just so saturated and everything. Wow. Almost there. Like 10 miles to go.
Well, now we find out if the kitties even remember me. Did you remember me? Do you know who I am? I'm your cat dad. It's been 36 hours, guys. Tara, I missed you. It's been 36 hours, guys. I missed you too. All right, I'll let you two eat and then we'll talk, okay? Because there's something we gotta talk about. I got something that I gotta show you both. Hello? All right.
Anyways, I decided to take a detour when I first got back because I was greeted, literally, when I got off the exit into my town, this is what it was doing. You couldn't even see the highway in front of you. It is so funny how every time I get back here, it rains and pours, and we now have a flood warning for the local river here, of course. Anyway, this video is getting super long. There's tons more camper van stuff to come, but I promised you that we were going to name the RV officially. I asked my patrons over on Patreon what we should name her, and we came up with some great, great ideas. Some of the top answers were Vanny DeVito, Pamela Vanderson, Van Diesel, Barry Vanilo. All great names, but I asked everybody to vote, and we are going with officially Vanna White. For all you Wheel of Fortune fans, you might appreciate that. We are calling the camper van Vanna White. Guys, have a good one. I'm gonna hang out with my kitties and get back to you in just 2 days. See you in 2 days, guys. Bye-bye.